With the school closed and Kenya Certificate of Secondary School examination postponed, a lot of students have found themselves confused whether they should continue with their studies at home. However, there are some students who have managed to set new goals and targets for themselves and continued with their studies when still at home. These students have realized it is more rewarding to study for a career as opposed to studying for an examination. In this video and my future videos, I'll help you come up with a clear plan and strategy to help you resume your studies. Moreover, if you're a parent or a guardian, my videos will help you come with a plan to guide your child in their studies. If you have an interest in pursuing a career in electrical engineering, or you are undecided on which career to pursue, and electrical engineering is on the table, then this video is for you. In the next few minutes, I want us to discuss which areas in mathematics you should be engaged in, instead of idling at home in the name of a postponed examination. In other words, I want you to start preparing for your career in electrical engineering now instead of when you finish high school, because by then it will be too late to avoid some mistake I've seen a lot of people make. Remember, the worst thing you can do is go through an education system without discovering your strengths and weaknesses. To identify those important areas in mathematics for a career in electrical engineering, we will quickly go through the mathematics syllabus for class in electrical engineering, diploma in electrical engineering, and higher diploma in electrical engineering. We will also go through the mathematics syllabus for one degree course and compare this with the mathematics syllabus that you are using in high school. This will help you take a course in electrical engineering from an informed position, but not throwing yourself in a course because you had somebody succeeded in it. I also make similar videos for other courses in engineering and sciences. Now let us jump to my computer and check the syllabus. Let us go through the various mathematics syllabus that we have. That is from craft in electrical engineering to degree in electrical engineering. I will later do videos for physics, the areas of physics that you should be concentrating on if you wish to do a course in electrical engineering. I also do some more videos on how you can transit from various levels of electrical engineering to the next. That is from craft to diploma, from diploma to higher diploma, and the requirement for each level. I'll do a video on all that. But what you're going to do, let us check the mathematics syllabus. How is it like? This is mathematics 1, electrical engineering craft. So we move down here. The first topic here is a number system and fraction. There's also fraction and decimals, which is the second topic. Notice these are the topics in form 1, the GCD, the LCM, the number system. There's a fraction and decimals, there's square root and squares, there's cube root and cubes, all those small topics that people do not take seriously in first year. Actually, they are in craft in electrical engineering, mathematics 1, and mind you, they are also very important in every other topic that you do. They're important in every single topic that you do later in your career in electrical engineering. If you move on down here, we have indices and logarithm. Notice that one is in high school. There are two different topics, indices and logarithm. And I guess there are two topics on logarithm. There's also matrices, which again in high school. There's sequence and series, which is again in high school. I notice how much retro time is allocated. Notice how much retro time is allocated for each topic. 8 hours only for indices and logarithm. Because it's assumed you did it in high school, so you are comfortable when you're now in college. There is also statistic. Statistic is another topic in high school. It's also in craft in electrical engineering first year. We move down to the second year. Year 2, Mathematics 2 for craft in electrical engineering. We check the syllabus for that. You will notice, what's the first topic? It is algebra. Algebra, which is in high school, only 10 hours. There's also trigonometry and hyperbolic function. Trigonometry is so important in electrical engineering. I don't know how much I can insist that. It's very important. It later evolves to hyperbolic functions, although hyperbolic function is not introduced in high school. There is also vectors.
there's vectors, which again introduced in high school. There's vector 1 and vector 2 in high school. There's also matrices. Matrices, again, is introduced in my high school. So those topics, take them very seriously. It is assumed that now that you did them in high school, you will be comfortable when you're doing your certificate course in electrical engineering. There's also another very important topic called calculus, which is introduced in high school in Form 4. It's also there in crafts in electrical engineering in second year of study. Now, let us move on to diploma. I have the syllabus for diploma here. So we check this first year of study of diploma is engineering mathematic 1, which is in first year of study. Let us move down here. The first topic is indices and logarithm. It's taken a single topic, but in high school there are two different topics. It's only allocated 4 hours only. 4 hours only. Why? It's assumed you did this in high school, so you are doing it for the second time, and therefore not much hours, not much time will be allocated for it. So instead of saying the exam has been postponed, take your book now, start reading. Stop reading for the exam, but lead for your career. The exam will pass, but your career will be there forever. You do not want to join a course and you start having problems because you never took mathematics seriously. And yet you had all the time, you have a whole year at home. Then there is a trigonometry, we have said this is very important. And in high school there is trigonometry 1, 2 and 3. In college, it will only be allocated 8 hours only. Because it's assumed you did it. Then there is a hyperbolic functions, we have said is a kind of extension of trigonometry. We also have inverse functions. Though not introduced in high school. This is another important topic. We have complex numbers. Again, this is very important in electrical engineering. It may not be important to mechanical engineers and civil engineers, but as far as electrical engineers are concerned, complex numbers is a very important topic. Though not introduced in high school, but is as the moment you do trigonometry and a few more topics like algebra, you'll be comfortable with complex numbers. There is also coordinate geometry. Geometry is introduced in high school. There's permutation and combination. Though I would say permutation and combination is not very important in electrical engineering, but it's there anyway in high school, and you also find it in first year of study. There's binomial theorem or binomial expansion, which you find in high school, is also in the first year of study in electrical engineering. If you move down here, after binomial theorem, there is the most important topic in electrical engineering, calculus. There is calculus 1, which include various methods of differentiation, and also there is calculus 2, which include various methods of integration. Take that topic very very seriously. Though it is on the last year of study in high school, that is from for the last topic, take it very seriously. If you move down here, in the second year of study, year 2, engineering mathematics 2, you find there is a vectors, which is introduced in high school, is vector 1 and 2 in high school. We also have matrices in the second year of study, again introduced in high school. There is also differential equations, which is again introduced in first year diploma through calculus 1 and 2. Differential equation, without doing calculus 1 and 2, you cannot actually be able to manage differential equations. There is partial differentiation. This topic is in first year of study and also in the second year of study for diploma levels. It is repeated in first year and second year. Then there is a Laplace transforms. Laplace transform, though not introduced in high school, is has some basics in calculus, differentiation. It also requires a bit of trigonometry. It also requires a bit of algebra and so on. If we move down here, you also have power series, and you have statistics. Power series is not introduced in high school. McLaurin and Taylor's theorem, they are not introduced in high school. But after doing some few more topics, it will be comfortable. Then there is statistics, which is introduced in high school. Take note of those topics. These are topics that you should be revising seriously. Not because you have KCSE waiting for you, but you know, if you intend to do a course in electrical engineering, it will become so important that you do not want to complain mathematics is difficult, and yet you had a whole year at home which you did not utilize properly. And then there is a probability, engineering mathematics 3, which is the third year of study. You have Fourier series. Fourier series, I would say, is 7% calculus. See how important calculus is. Multiple integral, again, 70% calculus, integration. Vector field theory, I would say, also is more than 50% integration, that is calculus. Calculus is very important. Despite the fact that it's taken to form for the last topic, it's a very important topic. Although it's also in diploma first year, but again, because it's assumed you did it in high school, not much time has been allocated for it. So do not say I'll do it in college. You should actually start taking it seriously. You also have matrices. Matrices 2, there's matrices 1 in diploma 2. There's also matrices 2, matrices 2 in third year, that is diploma 3. You also have a numerical method. Though not is high school, is also a very important topic. It requires you to be able to punch your calculator very quickly. There's also another topic called complex variables. Not in high school, but is introduced through completion of square. There's completion of square in complex variables. I usually have a lot of hard time with my student here. We move on to higher diploma. Actually, in higher diploma, they are simply the same topic we found in diploma. Let us quickly go through them. There's real numbers and binomial theorem, complex numbers, trigonometry, you have seen that is in diploma. Hyperbolic, you have seen it is in diploma. You have seen differential calculus, that is various method of differentiation, it is in diploma. Integral calculus, various method of integration is in diploma. You have seen that. That is substitution and all that. Permutation and combination is in diploma. Probability, again, you have seen it in diploma. Actually, if you have done a diploma in electrical engineering, the mathematics is just the same. It's only that. It's a little bit more involving than it was in diploma. Then there is also statistics. This again is in diploma. Partial differentiation, which is again in diploma. Differential equation, again, which is in diploma. There is statistics, again, which is in diploma. And there is matrices, which again is in diploma. This topic, harmonics, same as Fourier series, which you have seen is in diploma. And then there is also Laplace transforms. Again, Laplace transform we have seen is in diploma. If you now take the syllabus for high school, let us see what is actually there. Is it as the same as in colleges? There is numbers. Take this topic seriously. Numbers, factors. They are not only in craft in electrical engineering first year, but they also form very important topic in other levels. They are actually in every topic that you do. The divisibility test, the GCD. You are always required to find the LCM, no matter which topic you are covering. So it's very important. There's also integers. Take those small topics in Form 1 seriously. In fraction, you'll always be dealing with fractions. These are topics in Form 1. If you're in Form 4, don't struggle revising Form 4 syllabus. Go to Form 1 first. Square root and squares, take this seriously, the cube root. The reciprocals again, got Form 1, revise about reciprocals. The rate and proportion and percentage, got Form 1, revise them. I'll attach all the important topic for you to to the video description. You can download that document and use it to remind yourself which topic you have to take very seriously if you intend to do a course in electrical engineering. This one, EDCs, is very important in electrical engineering. We have seen that several times from diploma one, from certificate to diploma. This also for the logarithm. It means logarithm is divided into two in high school. Measurement combined with trigonometry become very important in electrical engineering. The Pythagoras theorem also is important because you need it in trigonometry. Volume and capacity form part of mensuration. They are important in electrical engineering. Algebra and algebraic expression and equations. They are very important. In every topic, you'll always be dealing with algebra. It's not something that you do in one topic and then forget about it. Equation of a straight line, this is very important. In fact, quadratic expression, take that seriously. You'll always require quadratic equation. This is very important. I always have a problem on expansion, this one. Students have problem with it, despite the fact that they did it in Form 2. This SADS is very important also. Take it seriously. You need it somewhere. Sequence and series, you have seen them. You have seen sequence and series in diploma and also in craft. You also have seen binomial theorem somewhere. You have seen the binomial theorem. You always need graphs, no matter which course. The graphical methods, this one also take it seriously. You always require them. They're important for electrical engineering. Now this is where serious work starts actually. You see trigonometry. Very important in electrical engineering. Take this seriously. And as we can see, you usually start with the trigonometry 1. I don't know whether in Form 2 or Form 1. There is trigonometry 2. There is also trigonometry 3. See how much important trigonometry is. Statistic and probability, you have done this in high school syllabus. In fact, there is statistic 1 and 2. This is also statistic from craft in electrical engineering to degree in electrical engineering. Is this statistic? Statistic 2. Probability, take that seriously. This is from craft in electrical engineering to degree. There is a vectors. And as we can see here, we start with vectors 1. Don't know whether in form 3 or form 2. There is also vectors too. We also have matrices. Very important. You have seen it in diploma, you have seen it in craft, you have seen it in higher diploma. There is matrices, transformation. Part of matrices, also very important. And we have seen there is differentiation in craft in electrical engineering, diploma. There is differentiation in higher diploma in electrical engineering. And then finally there is integration. Although integration is the last topic in high school, is actually very important. I would say it's the most important topic in electrical engineering, followed by trigonometry, then EDCs and logarithm, then algebra, and a few more topics there. If you take the degree course, I'll not take a lot of time with the degree. But you can see there is algebra. Algebra, there is EDCs and logarithm, and a few more topics like binomial theorem. See, SADS. Binomial theorem, that's algebra for degree level. There's also arithmetic and geometric progression and a few more topics. There's also complex numbers. It's the syllabus for one of the local universities. Then there is calculus 2. Calculus 1, which is mostly differentiation and application of differentiation, that is rate of change and so on. The stationary point, they're in high school also. So take that calculus topic in final year of study in high school seriously. This calculus 2, technique of integration is mostly about integration. And there's also the application of integration, the first and second order derivatives, and application of differentiation. equation of tangents and so on. Applied Mathematics, which is more of physics and so on. Calculus 3, which is again partial differentiation, matrices, the determinant and matrix operations. Then there is ordinary differential equation, ODE. Ordinary differential equation is again in all these in, I think by now we are in second year of study. Then there is calculus 4, this is in third year of study. Calculus 4, this is again requires a lot of calculus. It includes topics like multiple integrals, that is double and triple integral. There is also Lagrange multipliers. It also includes the vector field theory, that's Stokes theorem, Green theorem, divergence theorem, and so on. And also, it also includes Fourier series. Partial differential equation, PDE, which is not in diploma, but it is introduced through calculus. There's also statistics, and then there's also complex variables, complex analysis, and then numerical methods. These are topics in degree. They require you to be working hard right now. Now, I have this document I've created for you. I'll attach them to the video description. It is showing you how the topic transits from high school to colleges or from high school to tertiary education. For example, the topic you are talking about in first year, this is the number system, the GCD, the LCM, the cube, and the squares, all those. The reform number system in tertiary institution, they are also there in almost every topic we will do. Mensuration, trigonometry 1 to 3 in high school, they are very important in all this topic in electrical engineering. And there is elementary calculus. See this topic, elementary calculus, in the last two topics of high school, they are very important. They form the foundation of all these topics in college or in tertiary institutions. So these are topics that you should take them. These are topics that you should take very seriously. So I'll attach this document to video description. By then, I've also given you my email address. If you have something, a question or something you'd like to ask, you can send me an email here. Also, do not forget to subscribe to the channel. I've said I'll make more videos on how you can transit from various levels in electrical engineering, which areas of physics that are very important. I also make videos for mechanical engineering, civil engineering, IT, automotive engineering, and so on. So do not forget to subscribe to the channel so that you can get one of those videos. I've also created a timetable for you. Those topics that you have said they are very important, like the many topics you have talked about in first year, they are here. Give them some time. When are you going to revise them? From maybe October 1 to October 20th. Indicate the date here. How long will it be one session, one revision session? How long will it be? How many sessions have you allocated? The number of sessions. How many? The total amount of time you think you require for these topics. And then you can make a comment after finishing the revision. If you are a parent, ensure you keep this so that you can make the comment for your child so that they can revise effectively.
Remember, decisions are made at consequences forum. It is a task to deal with the present. I don't see the reason why you should keep your book aside for a whole year and then in future you start struggling with your course because you are only thinking about the examination. Get down to work and start revising mathematics seriously. If you are in Form 4 or in Form 3 or even in Form 2, start with a simple topic in Form 1 and then progress upward. If you start with a simpler topic, it will be more rewarding because it will be much easier to understand. And then you progress upward to Form 2, Form 3, and then Form 4.